So for folks who aren't familiar, Rider is a full stack enterprise AI company. We've been around since 2020. We're based in San Francisco. We have offices in London and New York as well. And we really specialize in scaling generative AI for the enterprise. So we have customers across the board, from technology customers like Dropbox and Spotify to insurance companies like Northwestern Mutual, retail, all across the board, really where we focus on solving real world problems with generative AI. And we have a full platform that I want to kind of briefly go over with you. The Rider platform is a full stack integrated platform for building everything from digital assistants to text generation and summarization apps to data analysis. And it's composed of a number of different pieces. So first is our Palmyra LLMs. These are top ranked LLMs that we actually build in-house from scratch and train. And I'll go over those a little bit more in a second. We also have our approach to graph-based RAG called Knowledge Graph to connect to all your structured and unstructured data. We have AI guardrails to help enforce regulatory and compliance across your apps and workflows that are configurable by customers. And then we have our whole developer platform called AI Studio and integrations that go along with that. And then kind of our secret sauce is our AI program management. We jump in with customers, help them build these applications, manage their data and programs to get up and running with generative AI. Another way to think about this from like a developer perspective is this underlying foundation of the technologies that we build and offer: our LLMs, our knowledge graph RAG, and our guardrails. And then over top of that, we have infrastructure and inference that you don't have to worry about as a service. And then on top of that, we have kind of the two branches of the Rider product, where we have the business side that are some out of the box and custom applications that we build for customers. And then we have AI Studio, which really empowers developers and business users to build on top of Rider. So to dig a little deeper into the technology, first I want to just mention the Palmyra LLMs. So these are special LLMs that we've built in-house and trained. They're trained on a trillion tokens focused on business writing. They're really designed for enterprise use cases. And we also have really strict policies around data retention. We never train our models on customer data. We don't retain customer data. So really geared for the enterprise. And they perform really well. They're highly ranked on Stanford Helm. They do really well in multilingual benchmarks as well. And then we also have some industry-specific models. In fact, today we just released two new domain-specific models, one for finance called Palmyra Fin and one for medical called Palmyra Med. And we'll post the launch release for that as well. So we really take our LLMs seriously and make them super performant for enterprises. I encourage you to go check us out on Hugging Face as well. Most of our models are up on Hugging Face, either through Apache 2 licenses or non-commercial licenses. So definitely go check us out on Hugging Face. The other part of our technology that I just wanted to call out is our graph-based RAG called Knowledge Graph. We've really worked over the years to develop a highly performant, low hallucination approach to RAG to connect to all of your data and make it really cost-effective and easy to scale and deploy. And our graph-based RAG has several different components to it, and I'll just call out a few of them. One technique we've developed is using a specialized LLM to build a graph structure. This is actually an LLM that we've built and trained ourselves to build out a graph structure from data. And then we store that graph structure as a JSON object in a Postgres database. Alongside that, we do some other techniques like retrieval-aware compression, where we condense your data intelligently and index it with metadata. We use a technique called fusion and decoder that actually infuses data points in the memory layer of the LLM, and this drastically reduces hallucination. And then we've built this really cool UI called transparent thought process that will show you step by step how the queries are breaking down into sub questions. And then these all feed into all of the LLMs that we have. And then we also have connectors for different data sources and APIs that you can use for Knowledge Graph. So that's just an overview of Knowledge Graph, our graph-based RAG. And of course, how does it perform? Like, all of that sounds great, but at the end of the day, how does it perform? Well, we recently released a new benchmarking report where we compared our performance to seven other approaches to RAG that use vector databases in some form. And we used the robust QA data set for that and really demonstrated some amazing speed and performance compared to these other approaches. And we're sharing links for that as well. So check that out. So now let's talk about AI Studio. So AI Studio is our platform for business users and developers. And it consists of kind of three major components. You have the no-code side for business users to be able to build applications with AI, Writer Framework, which is our open source Python framework, and then our API and SDKs. So we'll talk about each of these pieces. So on the no-code side, we have this UI for building either chat applications or text generation applications, where business users can actually go in and chain together prompts, use variables, connect with knowledge graphs, and build out these workflows from taking in different types of inputs, formatting different types of outputs, and you can deploy these applications with just a few clicks. What's cool from a developer standpoint of this is that you can actually embed these no-code apps inside of Writer Framework as an iframe. And so you can get this nice synergy between a business user creating an application and then embedding it into your own code base as well. And then Writer Framework is our open source Python framework for building feature-rich AI-powered apps. So it consists of kind of two major components. There's a drag-and-drop builder for dragging and dropping components for building out the UI, but then it's all just backed by Python code. And so you can have the full Python ecosystem at your disposal to edit all of the logic and manage the state and that kind of thing. And then using the CLI, you can actually just deploy with one command to the Writer Cloud, and we'll have additional cloud offerings coming in the not distant future. I also get asked a lot about just sort of more technical details about Writer Framework. One is that, you know, a lot of times when you have something like a no code or low code or drag and drop editor, it's very hard to do things like version control because that representation of the UI just gets stored in some database somewhere. What's nice with Writer Framework is that it's actually just storing the UI as a JSON representation. And so you can still check that into version control, share it with coworkers, that kind of thing. I also get asked a lot about sort of the underlying technology when you're deploying these applications. Writer Framework basically generates a Vue front end powered by a fast API backend. So it makes it really easy to customize, extend, all of that. It's also using the full Python ecosystem. It's not like an abstraction of Python or a DSL kind of reduction of Python. We use Poetry for dependency management in Writer Framework, so you can easily just add and manage whatever dependencies you need. It's also incredibly fast thanks to WebSockets. Whether you're editing in the in-browser editor or in an IDE of your choice, like Visual Studio Code, you'll basically see no latency between the two. It also handles state for you. It basically makes state a Python dictionary. If you've ever built any front-end applications, you know that managing state can be a real pain. You have to figure out which approach and which library you want to use, and Writer Framework kind of handles all of that for you. And then lastly, we have a nice AI module that basically can integrate in all of our LLMs and RAG and everything right into Writer Framework. And then the final component of AI Studio is the API. And so we have a collection of endpoints and some SDKs basically for integrating our AI technology into your own code base and applications and services. The major endpoints that you'll want to be familiar with, there's the completions endpoint, basically for text generation, where you'll send in which model you want and a prompt and some settings, and you'll get back a choices array. You can also set a streaming parameter to true and receive chunks back. And I've got the URL here for the full guide there. The next one is the chat endpoint. Again, these are sort of very standard for model providers, but you'll send in a model and some messages, and you can get back the choices array similar to other providers. And you can set streaming to true here and get chunks back for that as well. And then recently, we released a new set of endpoints for managing knowledge graphs and files inside of those knowledge graphs. I didn't want to put up every single endpoint here because it's basically CRUD operations, create, read, update, and delete for knowledge graphs and file managements. But generally, the flow of this would be that you would create a knowledge graph, upload files, and then associate the files with the graph. And then you can retrieve and manage those files, delete them, delete the graph. We'll soon have knowledge graph chat in the API as well. For now, you have the knowledge graph chat in the no-code side of AI Studio. And so you can manage the graphs and the files through the API and then use the knowledge graph inside of the no-code app. And again, we've got lots of documentation online. And so to get started with the APIs, you can either use the API endpoints themselves, or we have a Python SDK available through pip, and a TypeScript SDK through NPM. And both of those are up on GitHub if you want to check out the source code.